Hi, I'm Christina Sear, CEO of Detour. We make non-rectangular phones for non-rectangular people, starting with a phone in the shape of a circle called the circle phone. In my spare time, I am a hobby phone enthusiast, and today I'm going to talk about one of the easiest phone kits to put together, the RePhone Kit Create by Seed Studios. This kit debuted on Kickstarter in September 2015, and it's now available on Seed Studios' website for about $59, which is really affordable for a phone kit. I recommend this kit for ages 8 and above because it has a touchscreen and it's a 2G GSM phone that you can assemble in minutes. It's really fast. So as for the 2G part, many carriers have discontinued 2G support, but T-Mobile has committed to 2G GSM support through the year 2020. So because of that, we can still put this kit together, which is great. And if you have a T-Mobile SIM card in your smartphone that's nano size, you can use that to test the kit. If you don't have that, you can purchase a T-Mobile SIM, usually at your local drugstore, but if you can't find it there, of course, you can find it online. If you're having trouble finding that, another backup is Ting. Ting uses the T-Mobile bands as well. So let's get started. When you open the package, you will find an easy-to-follow manual with IKEA-like instructions. Beneath that are some cut cardboard, which you can use as a paper cover for your phone. Underneath that is all the cool stuff. Here's the 1.54 inch touchscreen, the antenna you can find underneath the touchscreen, the battery is wrapped in this brown paper package, the audio module is found here, the GSM BLE module is found here. There's a breakout board here, which we won't be using today. There's also FPC cables and rivets. In fact, there's two packages of rivets. So a note about the modules. These all come from a set called the Shadow Line, spelled with an X, X-A-D-O-W. There are more modules you can purchase if you want to add more functionality to your kit, like GPS, more LEDs, and sensors. Today, we are just going to focus on the basic kit. Let's go over the rivets first. There are three different sets of rivets. I call them small, medium, and large. The medium rivets are in a package all by themselves. Let's see if we can find them here. Here they are. These are two-piece click-lock plastic rivets, so don't try tearing them apart. You simply need to push them through the material and they will open by themselves to lock in place. I'll demonstrate one here now. See, they have a bottom and a top. And if you push it together, it flares out. There we go. See how it flared out? All right. So step one, let's connect the cables, the FPC cables, to the display ports, keeping the printed side of the cables up. So the flexible printed cables are in this bag right here, otherwise known as FPC cables. And they're very cute. They're 35-pin cables because you'll have 35 connections on each port. So you want to make sure to have the printed side up. See, this is the back, and you see the pads right there. You want to actually have Seed showing on the top, and of course it does say top right there. So we're going to go ahead and insert these into the port. There's a trick to doing that. Do you see the white line here? So you want to try to work it so that when you insert them, the flap is up on the port. And then after you've inserted it, you can flip this flap over, and you want the white line to be as far under the flap as possible. Let's see if I can do a better job on the second one here. It doesn't always do it every time, but that's kind of the goal that you're shooting for. There we go, I did it on the left one there. Let's go ahead and see if I can fix the right one. Yeah, sometimes they're not painted exactly where they need to be, or maybe the port is not the right length, but that's kind of the goal that you're looking for. So I always recommend for people to use the colored case instead of the brown paper case first, because it's easy to tell the direction because of the green and the blue. So we're gonna go ahead and put the display with the cables through here and push it through the back of the paper, of the blue side of the paper. And then we're gonna use our medium rivets and push those from the front, and we want them to go through both the paper and also the display that's underneath. So let's go ahead and try this first one. It's always the first one that is kind of the test pin. And let's see if we got it. Can you see that? Yep, it's flared out just correctly, and it has gone through both the paper and the display. So we want to go ahead and repeat that three more times. All right, let's go. So now we want to move on to the next step, which is connecting the antenna to the GSM BLE module. So let's stop for a minute and marvel at this little module. It was the first of its kind way back, I think in 2014, even before the RePhone kit came out. It combined a lot of functionality on just a little space. So you can see here is the SIM card slot. Here is the battery port. On this side, you'll find the USB port and the power switch. And then if you flip it over, you'll see that here's the module, the brains of the operation, the CPU and the radio module are both contained inside of here. So you can see capacitors. In my classes, I point out the capacitors and the resistors. You also want to be aware of this port here. And let me see if I can bring it up to the camera a little bit closer. So that round port there is for the antenna. Let's go ahead and put that on first. So this particular type of port for the antenna is called a UFL connection. So basically what that means is it's really hard to get on. So you wanna make sure that you have this little pin in here that wants to go in the little hole. And so you just try to align it as best as you can. And when you push it down and you hear a little click or a snap or feel it, then you know that you've got it on. One thing that you can do to test that is you can wiggle the antenna back and forth, and if it doesn't come loose from the little module, then you're set. So let's go ahead and hook the battery up next. So the battery is a little bit of a trouble to get out, but I'm glad that they package it as safely as they do. Right. So another thing that you can mess up on is getting the battery plugged in upside down. So how do you know if it's upside down or right side up? So if you look really closely on this side, you'll see some shiny contacts. But on the other side, there are no shiny contacts. So you want the contact side down, facing down in the port. So let's go ahead and plug that in. Another thing that you can check is once you get it plugged in, the red wire is on the left side. So go ahead and check and make sure that you have that all connected. So it's important to get these things plugged in first before you attach it to the rest of the unit. Let's go ahead and do that now. Okay, again, lift the flap gently and insert the cable. See, and this time I have the white line underneath the flap. Success! We know that's a good connection there. Let's go ahead and put in the radio module this time. Okay, we're connecting it to the flexible printed cable. Great. Okay, now this time we want to attach these modules to the paper. And we can do that by using the smaller rivets. Now the smaller rivets are in the bag with the large rivets. So large and small together, medium all by itself. Honestly, you can use the medium rivets if you just want to use the same rivets all the way around. But the smaller ones are kind of nicer because they stick up less. So let's go ahead and use one of these small ones. Now it's easy to get the, now this time, instead of poking the rivets to the top, you want to actually come from the bottom. So make sure that you have your holes lined up. I'm checking that now. And you want to push the rivets in from the bottom. You hear that click. That means that's successful. The first one's always kind of the challenging one. The ones after that are usually quite easier. Let's make sure that I have that going through the right way. Yep, I do. So, and you'll notice on the radio module is only pinned down on three corners. And I just made the mistake here, so this is a good way to check. So the reason why is because the microphone is on one corner and takes up that space. So you actually want to have the microphone on the top. And sometimes I do forget this when I'm teaching the class, but you find out as soon as you try to put that third rivet in. So we're going to try to pop out these rivets. We'll just realign it. And it's a great sanity check for getting those out. Okay. Let's go ahead and plug that in the proper way. So you can tell the microphone is supposed to be in the upper left corner. So why is there a port on both the top and the bottom of the audio module, you ask? Well, I'll actually show that to you right now. You can use an extra cable to actually connect it to the extension board. So let's go ahead and do that now, just to show you what's going on. So this is the breakout board, and the breakout board has a map which you can find in the instruction book. And each of these connections here, each of these vias, we call them, connect to a certain place on the board. And here, I'm so sorry, I'm looking through the camera, so I'm not able to see the letters as clearly as I could if I was looking directly at it. So I see I have it upside down. Sorry about that. Again. So let's go ahead and get that white line underneath the flap. So you can see here's A, B, C, D, E, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So if you look in the map in the book, it'll actually tell you what each via or port controls, and we'll look that up now. So for Arduino IDE controls, here's the map here. And that way you can map it to what you need to control. One of the best parts about this little kit. All right, let's go ahead and disconnect that because we're just focusing on the kit assembly at this point. So we'll go ahead and secure the audio module to the paper. Make sure that I have everything all lined up here. Yep. Okay, I have it in the right direction this time. It's good. All right. And we're going to go ahead and do the same thing with the GSM BLE module, the brains of the operation. And this one's a little bit trickier, honestly. So I've taught about 200 people to put these phone kits together. I know it may not seem like it if I'm making mistakes here. It's really hard to see the board through the camera that I'm using. But anyways, sometimes I give up on the smaller rivets for the GSM BLE module, which I'll do right now, and actually use the medium-sized one. So that's kind of a trick of the trade there. And the reason why you use the smaller ones is so that they do not stick out as much. But honestly, on the GSM BLE module, you actually have components that do already stick out quite tall already. So it's not as much of a issue. So for example, you can see here, let me see if I can show it on the camera. This is quite tall, but so is the battery connection back here. So yeah, it's just whatever you can get to work really at this point. I see a lot of students struggle getting this one attached. So I just recommend that they use the medium rivets to get over that sometimes. And it does seem to help. I'm glad that SeeedStudio encloses plenty of rivets so that you don't run out of them. And you can use them over and over again too, which is really nice. All right, last one in. Here we go. All right, we're all secure. So you want to go ahead and check the antenna one more time before you wrap up the phone. Let's go ahead and just make sure that it can rotate a little bit. Yep, it's rotating just fine. Okay. Let's wrap this baby up. Okay, so you want to make sure that the so generally in class we have it go over the tape or under have the wires to the battery. So I recommend that the wires to the battery go in between the two modules, and then you check the battery behind, and you want the battery in the portrait position, because when you fold it over, you don't want these little rivets. Do you see them sticking up? You want it to fit in between those little rivets. So it's easiest to do that when the battery is in the portrait formation. Also in the directions, it says to go ahead and take the sticker off and go ahead and put the antenna on this flap right here. I recommend to my students to actually wait until they decide which paper cover they're going to use, whether the blue one or if they want to color and decorate this cover. You can also find on SeeedStudio's website, and then also on Thingiverse, they also have the template for the cover that you can print out and make your own. So it's so cool. Okay, so anyways, this is approximately where the antenna goes. We're just going to put it together lightly right now, and we will fix it later. And you want to go ahead and fold this flap over on top of the battery. See how it goes there? And see how the battery is in the portrait formation. You want to go ahead and keep that as you fold over. You want to make sure that it misses those prongs. So go ahead and look carefully. Fortunately, it's protected by the paper. And then also the positioning of the prongs, it fits nicely in between those prongs. So, sorry, I'm trying to show you on the camera here. All right, so this is where we go from here. We want to go ahead and wrap this around, go ahead and make sure to crease, make sure to crease this paper here and also here as well. So you're gonna wanna feed this triangular tab through that narrow slot. And you just wanna pull it as much as you can. It's gonna bow out in the back. You want this to happen in the back. And you want these other flaps to bend around the side. So see how those are bending around the side? Okay, we're good to go there. That's good. So you want to go ahead and tuck this in. And basically at this point, I tell my students just to go ahead and fudge it a little all the way around. And pretty soon you'll find that it fits really nicely. Go ahead and fold that top flap over. Excuse me, I think that's the bottom flap. Nope, it is the top flap. So there's the top flap right there. And then go ahead and secure these with the larger rivets. So sometimes I have my students actually check that the phone boots up before they put these final rivets in. I'm gonna go ahead and put, we'll go ahead and put these rivets in this time because I know how to get them out. And so will you after a couple of times. Oh, I love this kit. It's just so great. So easy to put together. All right. Of course, as I say that, then having trouble on this last rivet. We'll go ahead and try a different one. Need to just bend that rivet. Okay. All right. So we're going to go ahead and put this flap back in so that it can stand up. Things are hanging in there. We're going to go ahead and turn it on. So the power switch is right next to the USB port. So here's the USB port. Here's your power switch right here. You want to press that down and don't release until you see green. So you're going to have an LED come on if your battery is charged. And it looks like this battery may not be charged. Okay, so normally, gosh, about 90% of the time, the battery is charged when it arrives. But out of 200 cases, I've had probably about 10%. The battery is not charged for some reason. And so you just need to charge it. But we're gonna go ahead and troubleshoot while we're here. So if you are not having the display light up, there's a couple things that you can check and we'll go over those right now. So first let's go ahead and make sure that the LED is lighting up. So let's go ahead and press that power button again. Nope, it's not lighting up. Okay, so it's most likely the battery. We're going to go ahead and check that. And I'm going to pause here because I'm going to go grab a battery that I know is charged. Hold on. Okay, so here we have the battery that is charged. We're going to go ahead and plug that in. But this is a great time to show you some troubleshooting tips. So we're going to go ahead and push in this power button. So you just want to push it in until it's green, and then you want to immediately release it as soon as it turns green. So check this out. We have a lit display. So fantastic. It shows that the battery is pretty much full, pretty much all the way charged. It is indicating that we don't have a SIM, so I'm gonna go grab a SIM too, so we could show that. Some other things that you may see is, so if your LED is lighting up, but the display is not lighting up, that indicates that this cable is not connected correctly. So you want to go ahead and shut everything off. We're going to go ahead and shut that off now. pretend that the display did not come on. And then you just want to check these cables. Go ahead and lift them up, make sure that they are firmly situated. Sometimes if you play with it too much, you've bent the flexible printed cable, and so you want to actually change that out. Fortunately, SeeedStudio does give you additional flexible cables to replace that. So they give you about two. Those do come in handy if you've been playing with that cable a lot. Then if the phone lights up, and so you get green here, but oh, look, the display is acting funny because I did not put this white line underneath the flap. So we're gonna go ahead and try that one more time. It's a great example of what happens when you don't have a correctly situated display cable. So when it's in limbo like this, you just want to go ahead and unplug the, and you can't turn it off with the power button. You want to go ahead and unplug the battery. So it's just stuck. It just needs a little help. So we're going to go ahead and plug the battery back in. There we go. All right. And go ahead and lift these flaps. I think it's this one that's causing the problem. We'll go ahead and try that. See if it is. See if I can get the white line. Yep, I did. I got the white line underneath. Let's go ahead and just try it, even though we just changed the bottom. But I bet that's what was causing the problem. Yep, it was. All right. And then once you attempt to use the phone, if you notice that the audio card is not working, so either the speaker is not working or the microphone is not working, you want to check this cable here to make sure that that one's connected. I know that it all seems obvious once it's explained, but I have to tell you, when you are putting together a new phone kit, it's a little disorienting, and it's nice to have these tips. So we're going to go ahead and turn this off. I'm going to go grab a SIM card. We're going to go ahead and test it out. Okay, so we have the SIM card. Here we're going to go ahead and with the power turned off, we're going to go ahead and insert the SIM card into the slot. You want to make sure that the notch on the SIM card here, so let's go ahead and show it there. Oops, my autofocus is in the correct direction. You want to make sure that the golden contacts are not faced up. You want them face down so that they meet with these golden contacts here in the SIM card tray. So it's a little bit of a game, you know, getting this SIM card in each time. I'm not the only one that has trouble. I notice a lot of students have trouble too. If you're having trouble, just keep at it. So you want to make sure that that little notch is, of course, on the left-hand side. But as it slides into the tray, you want to make sure not to overshoot. Do you see that little notch on the SIM card tray as well? So you want to make sure that it butts up against that little diagonal piece, that little gray diagonal piece. So I don't know if you can see that here. Maybe we'll try to hold this as close as possible so you can see. So that should be a good connection. We'll go ahead and test it out. Let's go ahead and turn it back on. Oh, there we go. And I accidentally turned it right back off, but you saw that there was no SIM card error message up in the upper left-hand corner. Let's go ahead and check. So if it was not seated correctly, you would see the no SIM error message right up there in the left-hand corner. Or I don't know that it's an error message, but definitely an indicator that your SIM card is not seated or absent. So let's go ahead and turn the phone off. We're going to add a ringtone, which is not included in the instructions for when you receive it in the mail, not in the printed instructions. But if you go to the forum, you can find out lots of really cool things. So with the phone off and having it connected to your laptop or computer rather. You can go ahead and upload an MP3 so you can see that I have it connected to my laptop here. We're going to go ahead and install, and it shows up as a USB drive. So we're just going to go ahead and copy over. Let me go ahead and show you that here. So we'll go ahead and copy over some MP3 files there. I have them here. Let's go ahead and do a dubstep. Let's see. I also like, go ahead and do this. Carly Rae, and this is the classic Call Me, and of course Call Me Aqua. Okay, so we're going to send this to the USB drive, and it's uploading those four MP3s. You want to make sure that your MP3s are short. You can see that the longest one, or the largest one that I have here, is 1.7 megabytes. You don't want it much longer than that. So we'll go ahead and switch back to the phone. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and disconnect. And boot up. Go. So you go ahead and find your music choices. In fact, we should go over all the buttons. So for example, if you want to make a call, here's where you would make a call. You can go ahead and type in the number here. Sorry that this is not focusing really well. Let's see. Nope. Not much better. Okay. So we'll go back. You can receive texts in this window pretty easily. If you want to send texts, you need to pre-program them using your computer and have some preset texts. If you want to hook up through the adapter board sensors, you can do that here in this window, or LEDs, you can do that here in this window. This window also allows you to play music, and I wish this was, there we go, get a little bit of focus there. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and look up the music. We have four to choose from. So we're going to go ahead and then the settings are right here for the brightness and the sound, for the volume. But if you need to change the time, you need to click on the time. So that's like a trick deal there. It stumps a lot of us when we put together the phone. So we'll go ahead and put it in 2018. We're in August. Can't remember what the date is. I think it's the 17th. Whoops. Come on, little button. There we go. All right, and we'll leave the time as it is. So there we go, we changed the date there. I don't know if you can see, sorry that's so out of focus. Okay, so we'll use the if this then that window to go ahead and add a command. We're gonna go ahead and set on a call from anyone, and we're gonna set the sorry, I'm trying to get the camera to focus a little bit better. Anyways, call from anyone. We're gonna go ahead and check that. We want music to play. So we'll go ahead and click on that. Let's go ahead and do the dubstep. Play it just to test it. Yep, that's working. So this is a trick. Tricky part in that you need to click the check mark to make sure that you confirm. So make sure that you click the check mark in order to confirm that that's what you want to happen. So yeah, that's it. We're done. Okay. That command's set. So if anyone calls me now, then it will play that music. We can just play it through this window. And you have to remember to keep your MP3s short because they will play on for quite a while when the call comes through. So we're going to go ahead and try to place a call. So I'm going to go ahead and dial it here. Yep, and I went through. All right. I don't know what number to call. That's not a private line. So we're going to go ahead and skip that part. But that's how you can make a call. And we'll go ahead and review that again. Just click the call button. You type in the number. Say, it's a good number, 555-1212. Let's give that a try. All right, so I made it through. Call completed. All right, if you have any questions, please post them in the comments. Thanks for watching, and look forward to seeing your posts and your pictures on Instagram of the phone kits that you made. Please be sure to tag Detour or the Circle Phone, and definitely Seed Studios when you make your RePhone kit. They'll love to hear from you as well. All right. Signing off.